Hi, I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and in this Mocha Pro quick tip, I'm going to be showing you how you can work more efficiently with 3D objects for export straight out of the Camera Solve module. So let's hop over. So I'm in my Camera Solve workspace. I have 3D turned on. And if we come over to the 3D objects on the right-hand side, I have my features with the static auto features here. So if I just select one of the green default features, what I can do is I can then come in and filter based off of that object that I have selected. And this will show me all of the green objects. If I want to add in more, I can select any of these of the same color. I can just hit plus, and that's going to add in that second color there as well. Or I can hit minus to take them away one more time. So in this way, I can come in and I can shift select all of my green default vertices, and I can just turn those invisible. And if I turn off my filter again, and now I can come back up here and maybe only filter on the visible dots. So this gives us a lot more or a lot fewer features to have to worry about. Now, this doesn't delete the features. They're still there, of course. So if we export out all of the features, then they'll come along with us. We can also just look at the invisible ones as well, if we want to select those back on again. And if I marquee select just a few features here, I can filter just with the selected as well. And again, maybe come in and add in a few more here, or take some away just with the plus and minus here. And all of these can be toggled on and off at will. And the final thing with this, we can have permutations, so I can filter visible plus certain colors, and that's just going to show them there. So if I select these three now, come in and export out my camera data, I can easily just export out those selected points into my file. One more thing that we can do, if we come into File Preferences, we have a 3D tab where we can choose the default colors for our 3D objects, so including auto features, meshes, surfaces. And we have a feature size here. So if we wanted to make these bigger and we get huge feature points here, or if I set this back down to 2, we have smaller dots that we can look at along there. Now, very quickly, there's also one other thing that I want to bring up here when we're talking about 3D and Camera Solve. If we look at our next shot and just play this back, this is going to be a slightly trickier shot to solve with just the auto solve. So let's just solve the auto one. And when Mocha Pro can't solve, we do get a description of why that's happening. So if we look at our error box, it says the error of 16 exceeds the 15 HPX error limit. So it means we've just got a bad solve on this case. Stopping solve for artist intervention. It means stop being lazy, Ben, actually put in some features themselves. We also have this open the solve output window. If I hit on OK here, this will tell us everything that's gone on with our solver up till now. And this will give us more information about what stage the solver failed at. And depending on your shot, it might even give you frame ranges for you to take a look at where it can't solve certain frame ranges. On this shot, it's just a bad solve because we've not given it anything to actually help it solve. So that's not going to help us. So those are just a few quick tips about how you can start to filter out your 3D object list, how you can set up your preferences for different colors, and what to do when your shot doesn't work. And of course, you should check out all of the other Mocha Pro tutorials we have available right there on boriseffects.com, or join us on our forums or Discord channel. Links down below. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. See you again soon.